for being here. Perhaps we can start off by you telling us a little bit about your experience as a gym manager and instructor and where you're based.
Thank you so much, viewers. My name is Armatin Obonyo. I'm a fitness instructor. Currently, I work at Silver Springs Hotel. I'm the gym manager at Silver Springs Gym and Spa.
Okay. Yeah. So you know a thing or two about what we're going to talk about. Hopefully you can clear up some myths for us.
Yes.
So we'll get into this discussion. If you have any questions about what we're talking about, saunas and steam rooms, you can go ahead and tweet at Citizen TV Kenya. Use the hashtag Power Breakfast. You can tweet me, @JOEY_Muthengi. I'll be sampling some of your comments. And you can also use the SMS line. It's 22422. So let's break it down. Saunas and steam rooms, closely related. We know that they're heated rooms used for relaxation. Some people say that they help to relieve some symptoms of certain medical conditions. But maybe you can start by telling us the difference between a sauna and a steam room.
Actually, it's true. We have, in simple terms, I can put in simple terms, the only difference that we have between steam and sauna is that steam is a moist heat, while sauna is a dry heat. Yeah, that is the main and the major difference between a steam bath and a sauna.
Yes.
Yeah.
But both of them are heated.
Both are heated.
Yeah.
One uses hot water to produce the steam. That is why it is called steam, mm-hmm. steam bath. While the other one uses dry air, and that is why it's called sauna.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I want to talk about why it is that people choose to go to these, steam baths and saunas. There are people who go to the gym specifically for that purpose. They're not there to work out. They're not there to do anything else. I just want to, you know, feel the heat and have all of this, my pores sweat and feel like rejuvenated afterwards. So what purpose do they actually serve?
I think to start with, first, I think most people who go to the steam and sauna, maybe they are not, that awareness has not been created to them to know the purpose of using a steam bath or sauna. Most of them who go there might think that they go to the steam and sauna to lose weight mm-hmm. or to burn fat. Actually, that is not what happens. Sauna is used for other specific benefits. Like if you go to the sauna, you will sweat. By sweating, you will be able to detoxify your body. You will also be able to have a good skin. It also helps with the proper blood circulation in the body, but it has nothing related to losing weight or
okay.
losing fat. The weight that people normally lose whenever they're in steam bath or sauna is water weight, and that water is normally very important now in the human body. As you know, that human body is 60-70% of water. So that is why you also normally encourage that whenever you are using the steam bath and sauna, you are encouraged to take a lot of water.
Yeah.
So that you don't lose that water.
Right, because anyway, like you're saying, if you lose water weight, that's weight that you're going to gain back anyways.
Yeah, you will gain it back. Immediately you take that water, you will gain that weight back.
Right.
Yeah.
I've heard it said that saunas are good for minimizing joint pains, like if after you've had a rigorous workout, going to the sauna is going to help somehow with your recovery. Is that correct?
Yeah, that is very true, especially athletes. We use the steam bath and sauna to relieve after workout pain, because when you go to the sauna or you go to the steam, when you get to that heat, you will the capillaries will open up, that will relax your muscles and also the joints. So actually, it's also recommended for those people who are suffering from things like arthritis mm-hmm. to use the steam and sauna mm-hmm. to relieve those joint pains.
Yeah.
So it is very true.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So these are areas that we should visit after a workout, correct? Not before?
Actually, you can visit both after or before, depending.
Either or,
yeah,
okay.
Depending on what has taken you there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. And how do I know which one is which for what? Like, how do I know? Should I go into a sauna for 15 minutes? Should I go to a steam bath right after? How do you?
No, actually, you can start with any. There's no specific reason why you should start with either steam or sauna. You can start with any, because basically both steam and sauna does the same purpose.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Also, maybe we can talk about the effects in terms of how these two do calm the body, just relieving stress in general. A lot of people leave there, like I said, feeling rejuvenated. So how important is that for just stress relief in general?
It is important, because once you go there and you relax in a steam bath or sauna, your body will detoxify. By detoxifying, you'll be able to sweat. all the toxins out of your body. Mm-hmm. It will also open the pores in your body. That making your body to breathe well. So after that, you'll be able to get a very good sleep afterwards. Mm-hmm. And that is why normally it is good for stress relief.
Right.
And things like that.
I've heard about steam rooms easing like congestion, if you have congestion in you. And it makes me wonder, you know, in terms of germs and bacteria and fungus and all those types of things, are they just kind of in the air while, you know, if somebody comes in and they're congested and they spend some time in the steam room, I come in after them, and how likely am I to maybe catch what they had if they're coming there to decongest themselves?
Yeah, it is true that sauna and steam bath can actually help with relieving chest congestion, like those people who are suffering from asthmatic problems or sinuses, mm-hmm. because it will ease your mucous membrane. Yeah, but true, it is very true that you can also be able to get bacterial or fungal infection from such places if they're not kept clean and well maintained. So that is why we normally encourage that a steam bath and a sauna should be well kept, well maintained, and well cleaned.
Yeah, but just as a precaution, isn't it also advisable for people to wear slippers when they're going in there, to have a towel, to sort of just in case?
Yeah, it is true. You are supposed to wear slippers. But actually, while you are in the steam or sauna, you are supposed to be in your bathing suit. That means you are supposed to be the way you were born. Mm-hmm. The only reason why you normally put on towels is like if you are using a public sauna or steam, only to cover your privacy. Otherwise, you are supposed to let your body sweat freely.
Okay, yes. Let the pores open up completely.
Yeah, so that the pores can open up completely.
You've said the weight loss thing is a myth. So it doesn't increase your metabolism to be in these heated rooms, to have your blood pumping? So
actually, I'll say it is a myth, because there's no scientific proof that has actually been proven that being in the steam or sauna, you can actually lose weight. As I mentioned earlier, that weight that you will lose in the sauna is water weight. And remember that water weight is very important in your body. Remember, water is one of the components that we require in our body to make us lose weight. Yeah, we require that water to increase our metabolism. So if you lose that water and don't replenish it back, mm-hmm. actually it might even inhibit you losing weight in future. So it is important that you take that water back.
So there is a concern there that you can actually get a bit too dehydrated if you spend too much time in these
rooms. Yes, it is true. You can get really dehydrated if you don't take
water before and
during and even after.
Okay. So
that is why you normally encourage people to take water before, during, and even after the use of steam bath and sauna.
What is the appropriate amount of time to spend in a sauna or a steam room, and how much time is too much time? Because some people kind of tend to overdo it and want to...
Actually, for the steam bath or sauna, you are actually supposed to spend between 10 to 15 minutes.
Okay.
Per session, you can go like 2 to 3 times. You do 10 to 15 minutes bout. You come out, have a cold shower, go back for another 10 to 15 minutes. You can do it 2 to 3 times.
Oh.
That should be enough for the day.
Okay.
Actually, most people normally overdo it. And when you overdo it, that is when people get dehydrated. And you have actually seen some people whereby when they come out of the steam or sauna, their skin doesn't look the way it was before.
Yeah.
They look dry,
yeah.
Because they have overdone it. Actually, you're not supposed to do more than 45 minutes.
Okay, but within the 10 to 15
within the 10 to 15
minute intervals.
Yeah, intervals.
You can
do
that several times.
You can do like 2 to 3 times.
Okay.
That should be enough. By staying too much in the sauna does not mean that you will get a lot of benefits.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How many times per week are we looking at?
We're looking at between 3 to 4 times, so it should be enough.
3 to 4 times.
Yeah, week. 3 to 4 times.
So what would you say, again, I asked this question earlier, perhaps we can expound on that, to people who substitute this for the workout? Like they're going specifically to get into a sauna or to get into a steam room and feeling like, you know, you're in a kata mafuta or whatever it is people say. You can't substitute this for cardio and everything else.
Actually, you can't substitute, and that is the myth that I really wanted to demystify today and make people know that by just going to the steam and sauna alone will not make you lose weight or lose fat or even build muscles for that matter. So you're supposed to use the steam and sauna alongside a proper gym routine,
yeah.
And a proper diet.
Yes.
Yes.
Absolutely. And that's yeah. that's another thing to consider, that this isn't going to take a place of a healthy diet. Just because yeah. you go to detoxify,
yes.
maybe you shouldn't have been putting the toxins in your body in the first place. Is there a certain group of people who are supposed to avoid these steam rooms? I mean, I'm talking pregnant women, maybe the elderly. Is there any...
Yeah, we actually discourage pregnant women from using the steam bath and sauna. And those people with severe high blood pressure and respiratory problems, we normally encourage, and as a fitness advisor, I would encourage those people to seek a doctor's advice before they get into a steam or a sauna.
Okay.
Yes.
You've talked also about making sure that you're entering into a clean facility, that, you know, so that fungus, bacteria, all of that is not just spreading around from the people who used it before you. Are there ways to know or to judge whether, okay, this one looks okay, this one is something I can use, or this one might not have been maintained properly?
Yeah, actually, the steam sauna is supposed to be cleaned each and every time in intervals after several people have used it. But in addition to that, we also use like disinfectants. We use things like eucalyptus oil, lavender oil, or rosemary oil, because these things can be used as antiseptics. They will be able to kill the bacteria and the germs in the air. So that is why we normally use those oils to ensure that the steam environment or the sauna environment is healthy for everybody who is coming in.
Yeah.
Especially if it is a group, it is being used by a public.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's important perhaps to inquire even from the gym management once you're going into there, how often is this cleaned? Whether they're using these antiseptics and those types of products.
Yeah, it is true. And most people actually talk about my place where I work at Silver Spring. We normally have that eucalyptus available for the clients each and every time that they get into the steamer sauna. We'll always put for them.
Yeah. Yeah,
and disinfect the place.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You've said that when someone spends too much time in these rooms, their skin comes out looking dry and not very attractive. But
yes.
if someone is using it properly for those 10 to 15 minute intervals, what are some benefits to the skin that we can expect to see, and how soon do we see those benefits?
Actually, your skin will look much younger if you use it properly. Yeah, because as I said earlier, it's supposed to detoxify you. Remember, when you are working out or you are doing your day-to-day business, you sweat a lot. And also the things that you eat and things like that, we normally have a lot of chemicals in our body,
yeah.
which are normally kept under the net, the skin. So by sweating out in the steam or in the sauna, you are able to remove and detoxify those kind of chemicals out of your body
mm-hmm.
by sweating. Remember,
yeah.
sweating is one of the ways to detoxify your bodies.
Mm-hmm.
So that is why it is normally very important to use the steam and sauna to detoxify, and after that your skin will pretty look much rejuvenated and
So you have glowing, more plumper skin and all that. Finally, just final comments on people who are afraid to use the saunas and steam rooms. There's a lot of, like I said, myths that go around about what these rooms are, what they do, what they don't do, and I think we've tried to break those down. But if there's one thing to someone who's perhaps never been to a steam room or a sauna at the gym or at you know, any public place, what would you tell them?
I would encourage them not to have any fear of using the steam or sauna. The only thing that they need to be aware of that is whether the steam bath is kept clean. And that is the most important thing. And also the proper usage of the steam and sauna.
Yeah.
Those two things are very key and important for those people who are going to use the steam and sauna for the first time. And if you are actually going to use the steam and sauna for the first time, it might really be a little bit uncomfortable to stay for about 10 to 15 minutes. You can actually start by staying for 2 to 3 or even 5 minutes. You come out. As time goes by, you'll get used to it
mm-hmm.
and you'll be able to do it even for a few more minutes.
Right, so you
yeah.
just have to train your body
you
and don't feel like you have to be in there
it,
for
yeah.
15 minutes
for
15 on the
minutes,
first
yeah,
time
yeah.
That you go.
Yeah.
Again, something else that you said that I think people should take away from this conversation, this is not a replacement for your gym routine.
Actually, it is not a replacement for your gym routine.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, as I said earlier, you're supposed to use it alongside your gym routine.
Mm-hmm.
That is proper exercise routine and a proper diet.
Yes.
Yeah, but don't. I discourage people from using it as one way of losing weight, because there's no any way that you're going to lose weight or even burn fat or even burn calories by just being in the steam
just
and sauna
sitting
alone.
Sitting down in a hot
so
room.
So I encourage those people who when they go to the gym, they will always, you will always call them and tell them, and they will say, I'm at the gym. Yeah, they're
what are you doing at the gym?
What are you doing at the gym? That is very important also to know that it is only, you will never lose weight, you'll never burn fat.
Yeah.
And you'll never even build muscles by sitting in the steam or sauna.
Yeah, again,
it's supposed to be used alongside.
And you said it doesn't matter whether you go before your workout or after, as long as you're properly hydrated.
Yeah, it doesn't matter whether you go before.
Okay.
The most important thing also, that maybe one point that people might can take home, is that it is better to use it earlier in the morning and later in the day.
Okay.
Yeah.
So those are appropriate times.
For using steam.
Reap the full benefits.
Yeah, to reap the full benefits
of saunas and steam rooms. So thank you very much, Martin, for stopping by Power Breakfast this morning and giving us a few tips on what we need to know about saunas and steam rooms. Perhaps if you want to share your contact information or how people can reach you, you can do that as well.
Yeah, thank you so much. As I said earlier, I'm Martin Odhiambo Bonyo. I'm a fitness instructor. Right now, I work at Silver Spring Hotel. I'm the gym and spa manager at Silver Spring Hotel. You can reach me through my mobile contacts, that is 0725-896-735.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. Thank you so much once again, and thank you for staying tuned to Power Breakfast.